So students, now let us start with our seventh chapter, which is information processing. You all know the processed data will be called as an information. Okay, so here obviously I think you would have came to know what will be this lesson about. These are about data and you're going to just play with data. That's what I want to say. Okay, so the first exercise, I'll just give some hints in every exercise. From that only you will be asked questions. Okay, in exercise 7.1, you have one type of question which is very, very important, which is like this. A question will be given, so you're going to game. Okay, it is a very, very interesting game because it is an eating game. Eating means whichever you choose, you should eat. That is, see this question. You want to have an ice cream or a cake. There are three flavors, chocolate, strawberry and vanilla in ice creams, and two flavors, orange and red. Actually, it is velvet cakes. I think everyone will like velvet cakes. In how many possible ways you can choose an ice cream or a cake? Okay, so five people will be selected for this game and you are also one of it. Okay, so you will be having five boxes in front of you all. Okay, so everyone will be given chances to choose either one of the boxes. So what is the possibility for you to get a cake or a chocolate? Any flavor you can get, but what is the possibility to get? First of all, you should be in that five. In that five people they are selecting, right? You should be one of them. Then only you can select one cake or chocolate, right? So the number of possibilities will be how many flavors and how many, that is how many flavors in cakes and how many flavors in chocolates will decide whether you can join them. Because if it is only four flavors, then you will not be able to join in that group. You will not be selected in that four. If it is five only, you will be selected, right? So the number of flavors decides whether you can join that game or not. So the number of possibility of selecting a cake will also depend on the flavors, the number of flavors. So it is, therefore, the number of, if like this question is asked, you should just write some points. What are given in the question? We are going to have either ice cream or a cake. Ice cream can be selected in three flavors and cake from two flavors. Both the events cannot occur simultaneously because both you can't do. That is, you can't select one flavor in cake and one flavor in chocolate. No, you can't. Only you can select only one of them, either a cake or a chocolate. So it is, it doesn't occur simultaneously. Okay, so the number of possible ways is 3 plus 2 5 ways. Like this many question will be asked. That is, one of the questions is very, very important, which can be asked in your exam. Okay, then in exercise 7.2, another very, very important two questions are very, very important. So let me teach you what is it. One is repeated division method to find the HCF and one is repeated subtraction method to find the HCF. Both are only to find the HCF, only the method changes. One is repeated division, another is repeated subtraction. Okay, so if like this numbers are given, what you should do means, I have already done the division here. I'll just teach you how to do it. First of all, you should see two numbers are given, 455 and 26. Okay, in this you should select the bigger number. Always you know 455 is very big number than 26, right? So just put it in the place of dividend. I think you already know what is dividend divisor. This place will be called as dividend. This is divisor. Okay, this is quotient and the last one you will get is remainder. Okay, so you should put it in the place of dividend. Okay, dividend. Okay, I have put and the smaller one in the divisor. Now you should start dividing. 26, 17 are it is 442. You get remainder as 13. Now you have another step. The larger number should be dividend. So we have done that. After first division, the remainder becomes new divisor and the previous divisor becomes the next dividend. Understand very well. This point is very, very important in repeated division. Okay, if you forget this and go on dividing, then that will become normal division, not repeated division. So let me explain with this example itself. Here, when you subtract this, you will get 13. So now 13 will become your divisor. Okay, and the previous divisor was there, right? It will become your dividend. Dividend, that's what, 26, 13 I have just put there itself. Okay, I didn't change its place. Now again, when you do, you'll get 0. You should do this till you get 0 in the remainder. Okay, so this is done till it becomes 0. The last divisor is the HCF. The last divisor is what? Here it is 13 divisor. Okay, so HCF is 13. Okay, the next one is repeated subtraction method. This is also very, very easy. Only I have given an example. 42 and 72 numbers are given and you are going to do repeated subtraction from this. So the bigger number should be taken as M and the smaller number should be taken as N. Okay, you have two numbers, right? So let us assume two alphabets, that is two variable for that numbers. So now always you should do, there is no rule, always you should do M minus N. You can sometimes do N minus M also according to the rule. I'll tell you what is the rule is. Always the number which is greater should be in the first. The number which is smaller should be in the second. I'll tell you why. See, 70 is M, right? So I'm doing M minus N because 70 is greater than 42. So 70 should be put in the first. So 70 minus 42 is 28. Then I already told you N value is there. Now this value got exchanged to this. That is, M will become 28. In the before place it was 70. Now it is 28. It will keep on change. The values will keep on change. Okay. Now you can see the greater value is N value only. It is 42, not 28. Okay. Now N value is greater means now you should do, since N is greater than M, we should do N minus M. So N minus M equal to 42 minus 28 equal to 14. Now, already we assumed 28 as M, right? So M value is there. Then the new value should be N. Okay. Now I am doing M equal to 28, we know N equal to 14. New value is N. So M minus N, because M is greater than N. M minus N means 28 minus 14, it is 14. Now you should do repeated subtraction till M and N becomes the same value. Here you can see already we assumed 14 as N, right? Now the new value is also 14, which is nothing but it says M value is also becoming 14. Then M and N are both same. Now the you should stop repeated subtraction here itself. Okay, so M and N equal to 14, therefore HCF of 42 comma 70 is 14. That's it. Very, very easy. Exercise 7.3, you have a different concept called at bash cipher. It is the game of alphabets. Okay, so first you should write alphabets in order. Like this you should write full alphabets. Then in reverse you should write. Like this you should start writing. Okay. Then A equal to Z, B equal to Y, C equal to X, D equal to W, like that. Till here it will be Z equal to A. Till here you should write. They'll be giving some sentence. See, for good morning, like that they'll give. See, I'm doing BED, bed I'm doing. Okay. Okay, you till this I am doing. So BED means, for that they will be given YBW. They will be asking to find what is this word through ATBASH cipher. They will ask. For that, first you should write in normal order the alphabets, then in reverse order you should write, then match the letters. The down letters should be matched with the top letters. Then Y belongs to B, V belongs to E, and W belongs to D. So you got bed. Like this only you should find. Like this questions will be asked in your exam. Okay. Also in exercise 7.4, you will be asked question like this. So the question is, you're going for a, you and your friend goes for a shopping. Okay. So you go today and your friend goes tomorrow. Right. So you buy a pack of 5 chocolate bars for rupees 175. And your friend buys a pack of 3 chocolate bars for rupees 114. Who saves more money? You are checking. So like this many questions will be given. They will be asking who saves more money. For that you should find what is the cost of one bar of chocolate. Because see, these two are not equal. 5 chocolates and 3 chocolates are not at all equal. 1 chocolate and 1 chocolate can be equal, right? So you should find the cost of one chocolate bought by you and one chocolate price bought by your friend. How to do that? It is very easy. Just you should divide, see, one chocolate bought by you. Like this you should write equal to. You should not write. In question you will be given some name. Some Arun, like that. Some name will be given. So you should write that name only. Equal to. You should take the whole amount and divide the divided by number of chocolates. 5. Like this you should do. Okay. Also, same. Price of one chocolate bought by your friend, like this you should do, and it is 114 by 3. Okay, here I am doing 35 rupees one chocolate. Here also I am doing 38 rupees. Okay, I'll get. So see, here you can see that one chocolate rate bought by you is 35 and another one chocolate rate bought by your friend is 38. Who saved more money? Obviously you. Saving means the cost price should be less what you have bought. So 35 means you are saving 3 rupees than your friend. If it is 1 rupee also, it is savings only, right? So 3 rupees also will be savings. So you save more than your friend. Like this only questions will be asked. You should be very careful to answer these type of questions. Okay.